the 20 books and 20 videos. The 20 books and 20 videos. We'll have number one, we'll have number two, we'll have number three, we'll have number four. The number four told us how 57 million customers can buy what you sell in 1 minute. Right now we are on the number fifth video or book. 5 mistakes every Nigerian leader has always made. Recently, I told someone that it's only God that does not make mistakes. As far as human are concerned, they make mistakes every minute, every day, all their lives. Some of the mistakes are deadly. Some of the mistakes are trivial. Some of the mistakes we make, they are personal mistakes. But when we make mistakes as leaders of a nation, it becomes a national mistake. There are 5 mistakes every Nigerian leader, they have always made. 5 mistakes. And these 5 mistakes has crippled Nigerians to become what they are right now. A leader is someone that saw something that will benefit the people of his country or the people of his kingdom, and he chose to lead them to this solution. Because the reason why every normal man wake up in the morning and is doing something that will solve his problem. There are personal problems, there are community problems, there are state problems, there are national problems. National problems involve the whole people in that country. Now, state problems involve the people in that state. Local government problems involve the local government, and community problems involve the community. Individual problem is your problem. Yes. But right now we are talking about 5 mistakes every Nigerian leader has always made. I call it mistake because I look at it that they are not aware that they are making mistake. But it is. Every man that has a farm as a farmer knows that when it is time of harvest, there must be seed that must be sown. If not, there's not going to be harvest. If there is going to be time of farming, time of sowing is sowing, time of weeding is weeding, and time of harvest is harvest. Now look at me right now. You will understand that this country as a nation, they have seed, they have tree, they also have fruits. They have fruits. They also have fruits. What is our seed? What is our tree? And what is our fruits? If a nation does not know her seed, does not know her tree, does not know her fruits, they will continue to be liability to themselves. You can be a liability to yourself. You can be a liability to your family. You can be a liability to your community. You can be a liability to the whole country. Nigerian leaders, they always make 5 mistakes. And I know when you hear this, you want to be curious now. You want to know what the mistakes are. I don't want you to be in a hurry. In about 12 minutes from now, I will give you one by one each of these mistakes the Nigerian leader has made from 1960 when they got independence till today. Nigeria as a country have never created assets. there have always been a country of liabilities. We're always consuming what we have and wait for the next budget to come and continue to consume it. It is true that a nation takes the taxes of the country and uses them to grow the economy. Every dime, one naira that comes into this country belongs to the whole country. So no man has the authority to spend it on him or herself. No leader that can do that. And I want to shock you right now that one of the qualities of a leader is he solves the problem of his or her people. Nigeria as a nation took over from the British. And the very moment our leader took over from the British, they lost their dreams. That's one of the mistakes they made. The Nigerian leader lost their dream. They forgot that they were under the British. And what they saw that made them took the government from the British, they forgot it. They're beginning to look at themselves individually and what will benefit them. That's one of the greatest tragedies that can befall a nation. That inability to see the world as a leader and continue to change things that need to be changed to transform a nation. Our leader lost it. They're beginning to think of what benefits them. And in their thinking of what will benefit them, they now build a class. They now build a class where only them will benefit from the country. They created a political class from that 1960 to today that continue to run the affair of this country, and the Nigerian people were not carried along. That's a big mistake. In their action to want to build the political class and protect themselves, they abandon the real resources of this country. The resources of this country are not the oil well. They are not the cattle that are coming from the north. They are not the yams, the rice, and beans. The real resources of Nigeria are the human being. Now, they lost the focus of why they took over Nigeria. Or they had no plan when they want to collect the independence from the British. Because if indeed they have a plan, Nigeria will not be where it is today. We have cattle in this country, even before the British came in. From that time till today, Nigeria do not have a cattle ranch, neither do they have a meat industry where meat can be slaughtered, prepared, and beginning to be sold to Nigeria wherever they are. They are still using trailer to take cattle from where they are to every state of this country. Do you know the implication of that? It means we are not growing. It means we don't know how to turn that business to become an asset. It's still a liability. Let me end that there. We refuse to educate our children. We refuse to give them the education that makes them to see Nigeria as an asset and refine this country to become a great country. I want to shock you. When Nigeria had our independence in 1960, Malaysia, Singapore, Dubai, and China, they were nowhere. They were still poor. So what is it that this country had that we are not having? Nothing. We are where we are today because we failed to do the things we need to do. We saw something different, and that something different made us to create liability. Now, in the creation of this political class where our leader made mistake, where they forgot the vision, where they got independence, you know what they did? individuals are beginning to want to become the only important person in this country that will lead this country forever. Now, when these leaders saw that they cannot live forever, they're beginning to build God-fatherism. When they leave positions, they plant their schools or people that will continue to work for them even while they are not in office. In that behavior, they kill Nigerian development, they kill Nigerian growth, they kill Nigerian transformation. Because you don't build a country with your own mind. You build a nation with a collective mind of the people. The refined collective mind with an idea, with a vision, with a mission, with a goal to achieve results. This political class were only working to protect themselves and protect their children and protect those they have created to represent them when they're out of government. That's another problem they cause for this country. That is a mistake. Another mistake the Nigerian leader made was that they were not responsible to manage the wealth of this country. Instead, the wealth was wasted. $12 billion for 20 years can feed Nigeria if they are used to industrialize farm for this country. Instead of these leaders to create system, they're beginning to use their minds. And in today's world, there is no economy that can grow without a healthy system. Instead of them to build an enterprising mind, capitalist mind where people invest their capital to create and develop economy, they use the government to run all the affairs. And when you have an idea, the idea will die. No healthy enterprise, capitalist entrepreneurship mindset to drive the economy. Instead, the political class will decide how to build a bridge. They will decide how to build a road. They will decide how to build a house. They will decide what to do in everything. Now, the shocking aspect is, how can the people in government see what is good for the people without asking the people what they need? That's another mistake they make. Only the government do not have the resources to build the country economy. Look at US. They are not running the economy where the government is rich and the people are poor. But they are building infrastructures that help the average Americans to create wealth that will grow the people. Do you know how much Bill Gates is making for US? Do you know what Amazon is making for US? Do you know what Google is making for U.S.? Do you know what Facebook is creating for U.S.? Did you see how the wealth is growing? All the oil company in U.S. does not belong to the United States of America. No, they are individually owned, but the government protects them and collects taxes from them. That's how what this nation is supposed to be. Nigerian leaders fail in this regard. That's why they did not appreciate our real resources, and that is, they are human resources. That's the fourth mistake they made. It is Nigerians that will grow. Can you imagine somebody like Dangote? We have about 1 million of them in this country. Do you know how this country will be? For Dangote to survive as one of the richest men, he must have fought a lot of setbacks. And now, most of the people who did not rise up to be like Dangote. Not that we didn't have people with ideas, but the problem is that the policy of the government does not give people the avenue to grow. Imagine something like electricity today. If the Nigerian average man can buy a generator to generate light, why can't we have a stable now? Because of the government policies and the people in government, what they benefit from that bad policy. That's another great mistake. an open free market will bust the chart of Nigerian growth. Yes, yes. Another mistake, the fifth mistake that the Nigerian leaders have always made is that they are thinking that they can do everything by themselves. And so the Nigerians are not evolved. The Nigerians become destitute, they become militant, they become Alamajeris, they become Boko Haram, wasting while one man and few other men control the economy of the nation, the remaining part of the Nigerian people are suffering. These are the five mistakes. They did not see what Nigeria will be in 60 years. They did not value the human resources, the second one. The third one is, they want to hold on to the government for life. And if they cannot, they're beginning to plant the people of their choice. That's the third. The fourth one is, the government, instead of being an asset, become a liability, because the real resources the country is earning is being wasted. The resources that come from oil are supposed to be a seed to create a tree that will bear fruit. It is the fruit we are supposed to be eating. Let me tell you what I mean. China is building a tree all over the world. The fruit is what will come out from this allies, this friendship, these resources that have been planted in places all over the world. Can you imagine the South Korean build Samsung to be so big that wherever you go today, you see Samsung. Whatever resources Samsung is earning, it comes back to the country. So we did not support the people to grow. Instead, we throw them away. We didn't value them. That's a big mistake, because only you, the leader, cannot run the government affairs. The fifth aspect is, instead of the leaders to protect the wealthy, those with ideas who will create money for this country, they protect their political allies, political friends, who will help them to be in government, but they have nothing to turn the government around. They will collect money from the government, collect money for themselves, live big while the country is suffering. These five mistakes are serious mistakes. Our leaders should look into them and find a way to stop them. If not, it will not be possible for this Nigerian economy to grow. But we believe, as we continue to press on and negotiate with them, they will see. Can you imagine a country like Nigeria? You don't have somebody that will beat his chest and say, I want to change how we can have 24-hour life. I want to build rails. It is not only the government that build rail. It is not only the government that build bridges. It's not only the government that build roads. It's not only the government that will bring money to create big farms. But there ought to be system. These systems are called infrastructures that are partnership with business entrepreneurship mind that will blow the economy. That's what we need. Because the bureaucrats that are working for the government can't see everything, can't know everything, may not have all the ideas. That's why we are coming up with a poverty eradication system. We are coming in partnership to work with the government. Yes, we have ideas that can transform the economy, that can give us 24 hours light. The government should look into it and give us an open door. We want to build an electric train that will travel the 36 states. So that your journey will be faster. We have systems that can duplicate 25-3 bedroom flat every day in every state. Build cars for people. Turn the jobless people to become businessmen and people who are working towards the benefit of the country. When they have companies and they are shares of the company, they'll be committed. But how will somebody work for 40 years for a company? He's not a shareholder. At the end of the day, you just put him out that he's old. Give him his allowances and retirement, and he looks back for the 40 years he worked for the company, he owns nothing. It's not motivating. So these are areas the World Poverty Eradication System is coming up. The government cannot succeed until they have Nigerian person involved. Now, when we talk about Nigerian person, we are talking about a Nigerian who has an idea, like Zuka Park, and the American government protected him to become somebody. They gave him the protected right. That was the same thing they do to Bill Gates. They are doing the same thing to Amazon. They are doing this. So with this right, nobody encroaches and you are protected. You will now begin to blow. We have a lot of wasted human being resources in this country. Now, when we talk about resources, it's not just school education. It is what you have in your mind. It's your purpose of being created. It's your purpose of being born. You were not, God did not make a mistake for you to be born in Nigeria. Yes, but you can't be here and be useless. You have to be useful. And nobody is useless in this country. But the system makes them useless. We want an open system where we can be useful, we can partnership with the government, not only expect you to get from the government, but we can give to the government. And at the end of the day, it becomes a win-win game, and all of us will become successful. This is what we see, and our past leaders have already made a mistake. But right now, we want to let them know that these ways of their running the economy, the government, is not going to grow the government. We need entrepreneurship mindset, entrepreneurship partnership with the government, where road, trail, air, and all that could be owned by individuals, and they would transform the economy. Like we have MTN, like we have Glo, like we have Airtel, they are not government owned. So why can't we make things like petroleum, transportation, railways, and all that, electricity, owned by individual? They have the resources, they put their infrastructures on ground, they generate the light, distribute it to the people. Competitive economy, Nigeria will transform if these five mistakes are looked into and they are worked upon. God bless you.